Welcome to Grab & Go Info. Today I will talk about how to use AutoEncoder for anomaly detection. AutoEncoder is an unsupervised neural network model that uses reconstruction error to detect outliers. The reconstruction error is the difference between the reconstructed data and the input data. AutoEncoder uses only normal data to train the model and all data to make predictions. Therefore, we expect outliers to have higher reconstruction errors because they are different from the regular data. In this tutorial, we will use the Python Tensorflow Keras library to illustrate the process of identifying outliers using an autoencoder. To be specific, we will cover what is the algorithm behind autoencoder for anomaly detection, how to train an autoencoder model, how to set threshold for autoencoder anomaly detection, how to evaluate autoencoder anomaly detection performance. Let's get started. The first step is to import libraries. We need to import make classification from sclearn to create the modeling dataset. Import pandas and numpy for data processing. Counter will help us count the number of records. Matplotlib and seaborn are for visualization. We also need the train test split to create training and validation dataset. TensorFlow for modeling. And classification report for model performance evaluation. Using make classification from the sclearn library, we created two classes with the ratio between the majority class and the minority class being 0.995 to 0.005. 32 informative features were made as predictors. We did not include any redundant or repeated features in this dataset. The third step is to do a train test split for the imbalanced data. In this step, we split the dataset into 80% training data and 20% validation data. Random state ensures that we have the same train test split every time. The seed number for random state does not have to be 42. And it can be any number. The train test split gives us 80,000 records for the training dataset and 20,000 for the validation dataset. And we have 79,200 data points from the majority class and 800 from the minority class in the training dataset. Minority class data points are outliers or anomalies. In step 4, we will talk about how the autoencoder algorithm works. The autoencoder model for anomaly detection has 6 steps. The first 3 steps are for model training. And the last 3 steps are for model prediction. Step 1 is the encoder step. The essential information is extracted by a neural network model in this step. Step 2 is the decoder step. In this step, the model reconstructs the data using the extracted information. In step 3, we iterate step 1 and step 2. The goal is to adjust the model to minimize the difference between input and reconstructed output, until we get good reconstruction results for the training dataset. Step 4 makes predictions on a dataset that includes outliers. In step 5, we set up a threshold for anomalies by comparing the differences between the reconstruction value and the actual value. Step 6 identifies the data points with the difference higher than the threshold to be outliers or anomalies. The autoencoder model trains on the normal dataset. So we must first separate the expected data from the anomaly data. Then we created the input layer, encoder layers, and decoder layers. In the input layer, we specified the shape of the dataset. Because the modeling dataset has 32 features, the shape is 32 here. The encoder consists of 3 layers with 16, 8, and 4 neurons, respectively. Note that the encoder requires the number of neurons to decrease with the layers. The last layer in the encoder is the size of the encoded representation, and it is also called the bottleneck. The decoder consists of 3 layers with 8, 16, and 32 neurons, respectively. Opposite from the encoder, the decoder requires the number of neurons to increase with the layers. The output layer in the decoder has the same size as the input layer. The ReLU activation function is used for each layer except for the decoder output layer. ReLU is a popular activation function, but you can try other activation functions and compare the model performance. After defining the input layer, encoder layers, and decoder layers, we create the autoencoder model to combine the layers. Then, we compile the model with Atom as the optimizer. Mean absolute error is used as the loss function. When fitting the autoencoder model, We can see that the input and output datasets are the same, which is the dataset that contains only the normal data points. The validation data is the testing dataset that contains both normal and anomaly data points. 20 epochs make the model go through the whole training dataset 20 times. Batch size of 64 makes the model use 64 data points to update the weights in each iteration. Shuffle equals true shuffles the dataset before each epoch. This chart visualizes the training and validation loss changes during the model fitting. The x-axis is the number of epochs, and the y-axis is the loss. We can see that both training and validation losses decrease with the increase of epochs. Now that we have an autoencoder model, let's use it to predict the outliers. Firstly, we use predict to get the reconstruction value for the testing dataset. The testing dataset has the usual data points and the outliers. Then we calculate the loss value between actual and reconstruction using mean absolute error. After that, a threshold is set to identify the outliers. This threshold can be based on percentile, standard deviation, or other methods. We use 98% loss as the threshold to identify 2% of the outliers. The visualization chart shows that the prediction loss is close to a normal distribution with a mean of around 2.5. The prediction loss threshold for 2% of outliers is about 3.5. When there is a label for anomalies in the dataset, we can evaluate the model performance. Based on the threshold we identified in the previous step, we predicted normal data points if the prediction loss is less than the threshold. Otherwise, we predict the data point to be an outlier or anomaly. We label the normal prediction 0 and outlier prediction 1 to be consistent with the ground truth label. The recall value of 0.01 shows that around 1% of the outliers were captured by the autoencoder. In this tutorial, we went through the autoencoder neural network model for anomaly detection. Using the TensorFlow Keras API in Python, we covered what is autoencoder, what is the algorithm behind autoencoder anomaly detection, how to train an autoencoder model, how to set threshold for autoencoder anomaly detection, how to evaluate autoencoder anomaly detection performance. If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. I publish tutorials on machine learning, deep learning, and natural language processing every week. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the code and explanations in this video. To learn about detecting anomalies using a supervised model, please refer to my video on ensemble oversampling and undersampling. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.